also is a Fuzawa Yokichi, very well known philosopher and the founder of the Keio University in Tokyo. He was born in the late 1800, not the beginning of 1800, and he came to the United States as the correspondence person and three times, Kanrin Maru. Then he started school, and at that time was Japan's history was a big change, Meiji Restoration and big change. So he started school, then not for the his university, but his principle, how to live, how a person should be, can be. So this is three various principles he left. And the first one is, what is the most joyful living in life? That is to have the job you enjoy throughout your life. That's the most joyful and fine way of to live. Do you know Japanese history, people have their job, any job, samurai and craftsman, farmers, and every social status, but they start different ways, but they devoted their life to your job and enjoy your life throughout your life. So that became the Japanese tendency to do your best for your job. The work ethic is very nice work ethic Japanese have. So then he sees that. So that's encouraged people say most enjoyable life is the fine job. No matter what kind of job, he doesn't say it's good, this is bad. But kind of job that you like and then enjoy that job throughout your life. That's the most enjoyable life. That's first. So there's many principles he left. That we're going to show only positive ones, but at the same time, he left. Don't do this. Better not to do it. No, better not to be that way. For example, most miserable life in your life is cultureless person. Culture is not only know the knowledge, how to behave, how to treat other people, as a human being and being in the society, how to act, how to interchange with the other people. So if you don't have that basic background as a person, that's a very miserable person. That's he said. Okay, another no-no is the most lonesome thing happen in your life is you don't have a job to work for. So everybody have a job and you can put yourself into that job. It's a happy person. So if you don't have that, it's very sad. Right. And then third thing, it's not pretty. It's not the pretty sight is to admiring other people's life. So you do that person have something I don't have. That person is doing better, I can't do. looking at other people's life, compare your life, and I am not good. That's very, very sad life. So he said, don't be that way. Okay, then last one, the sad, very sad thing, lie to other people. Lying is bad. So they are, yeah. There's some writing in the summer. So in any religion, you say, as a person, you don't do this commitment. And then in the happening, I am a Buddhist, and the saying is, do not lie. Very important in the Buddhist principle. Then so those are the plus and the minus. I mean the positive way of looking at a principle and the negative way of looking at a principle, and so if you want to be that way, be that way. You don't want to be this way, like lying to other people, and you don't have a job to work for, and then you don't have a culture, not as a knowledge culture. You become your, you make yourself happy and work on something and do something. So if you don't have anything like that, you are not. Now, the first one came. What is the most enjoyable life in the life is to continue and accomplish your work throughout the life. You can continue and, for example, the 30 years you have worked. Any kind of job, but completely one job for 30 years and retired happy. That's the most enjoyable life, he said. Because today's situation changed, so people easily change for work, and then tendency to be encouraged that way. So the time is different, but this is 1800. So that time, Fukuzawa Yukichi said, have job or what to do throughout your life. That's a very enjoyable life. Okay. Second, what is the most admirable, respectable life is to do something for others, volunteer work, anything, to do something for other people, not only yourself, not be the selfish person. To think about other people. And if you do something for others, you say, I did it for her. I did it for him. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't expect any return. Just to do from your bottom of heart. Do something for others. That's the principle of giving. Because only how sad it is to just me, the life of the me, that's not beautiful. And three, most beautiful thing in the life is to love everything. Love human being, love for animal, love for nature, love for chairs, everything. You touch and face, see it. Love everything, you see it every day. That's the most, if you can continue to have that mind, love for other people, love for other things, the most admirable, beautiful, living thing. That's the principle. Okay?
Yeah, no, but it's
So we still have motivation. So the last thing is very simple, but it's very difficult to do every day. Last thing, don't do it. Saddest thing in the world is lie. Don't lie. Even the small lie, white lie, don't do it. It's not easy, but that's his teaching, Kuzawa. So he became so famous, and he's a back of the $10,000 bill, Japanese yen. And he was $10,000 bill. Okay, so these are the his teaching that time. Remember the time, the 1800. So it's different from today's world. Situation is different. But don't lie, because that's the saddest thing. The first one is a joyful thing, is you have a job through alcohol job. Not the one, but any job you can devote yourself to the job. Because that time, money is not exchangeable your work. Not, we don't see that way. You work something very, very nice, or the devote yourself to the work, accomplish, you feel better. And as a reward, you get paid. That's an extra award. So that's what the people really like, get the money, what you are doing, right, or the enjoy. Thank you.